Okay, it's Sonia Devine here again, and I thought I'll just do a little bit more. Got a bit of peace suddenly. The girls have gone upstairs, and so I feel like I want to do it just a little bit more to this portrait. This steps one and two on YouTube. Sorry, I'm shuggling about there because I've got my palette on top of the stool that's attached to the camera. I'm just going to clean out. Clean out the middle of the palette, and my water could be cleaner now, but you know, I'm just going to stick with what I've got. And I'm using some of this cadmium yellow. I feel like I want to warm up areas and maybe move it on a little bit more, then a little bit more swiftly in the area of the skin. Like, so for example, this ear, that's too bright a color for that ear. So I think I'll use it rather than get rid of the bright color. I'm going to use it where I see the brightness. Where it changes from dark to light often can be warmer and brighter coloured. And this corner I had painted in yellow ochre originally, and I think I could do it a little bit of more sunny, warm tones. So the cadmium red there and the mixed with the cadmium yellow seems to give a warmth that I think works for the skin there. Here and there to give a bit of, bring in something that's more colourful into the mix, and still keeping enough blank space too that it's not completely full of paint. Like, I don't want every single part to have a value to it. Well, at least I don't want every single part to be dense with colour. Just here and there. A little bit of a warming up. If you saw the other two videos, I might post this one to Instagram if I can, although Instagram's not playing ball with me recently. And I've tried to upload videos there, it says waiting for bandwidth to improve or something. So I might just end up putting this one on YouTube as well. But then, what was I going to say? I think I was going to say that in the first two videos, you might have heard that the girls are trying to adopt a stray cat that's been wandering around. They've been feeding it in the kitchen. And it's apparently great friends with Margot. But it looks a very healthy cat. I don't think it's a stray. They think it's starved and everything. But it looks quite healthy to me. I think he just particularly liked the expensive cat food that Midnight only eats. He was delighted with that feed, right, I'd say. We'll see. I hope he doesn't keep coming back, because it's fine to stay outside, but I don't want more animals in the house. We've got enough animals. Right. And then Lily caught her finger in the door. You might have heard that awful crack in the first video. But I think it's okay. She was fierce worried because she's got her practical music exam in a few weeks' time. But really, I think it was just a very sore, bruise, like I'd say. Hopefully there's nothing broken there. We'll see now. Though she fears over the next few days, but yeah, it looked like it might be okay. Now there's an ear, very, very faintly visible in the shadows over there. So I'm just putting a touch of cadmium red into that side where the ear would be. And now that I've brought a little bit of colour into the right side of the face, I think the right side of the beard is calling for some colour as well. And that colour, I think, needs to be cerulean blue. And quite clean cerulean blue. Clean as I can get it with the water being so dirty. So I'm just going to half close my eyes and paint. You know, now a few patches where I see the mid-tone cerulean blue sitting. And the darker tones too. I'm filling in with my eyes half closed. I'm wanting to see where the particular darks and lights are located. And I'm not worried about creating texture or anything. I'm just doing my best to find the position of things. And then I think that the texture of the beard will kind of happen on its own. And I'm looking keenly at the shape of things. I'll try some viridian green actually. Bring a bit of an edge to the right side of the beard. So here's some viridian green going in. Maybe indicated too on the shadow side. Maybe that could also be used for the eyebrow on the light side as well. Just bring a bit of colour in there. And I think I won't be able to avoid the other eye for long more. But I might need to start another video. If I am hoping to put this on YouTube. No, if I am hoping to put it on Instagram, I mean. Because I'm supposed to keep these to 15 minutes for Instagram. This is a bit shorter, so if I was to keep it even shorter than the 15 minutes, hopefully it might be more likely to upload then. Just trying to figure out what the nose is doing. And I'd say the camera and my iPad's going to run out of charge soon as well, so that's another thing to consider. Let's see. Looks a bit strange what I've done there. It's kind of thinning in the nose too much, I think. So it might just break in. Well, that little bit is just sticking up too much as well. I want the spherical end of the nose to be a clean shape. And if I, rather than lift out the dark I've just put in, I think I'm going to mirror, I can't say that word. I'm going to do a similar dark down here. Similar tone of dark, anyway. Just sometimes if you do a thing in a few other places, it doesn't read as being so alien then. And can bring your painting on a little bit further. Yeah, so rather than lifting out this dark by the nose that I thought was a bit severe looking, I put a similar tone elsewhere and I think it's okay. This is dried a bit. I can, I think, find some lines or some more clear darks. So using a denser portion of ultramarine blue and Van Dyke brown. And the Van Dyke brown that I use is made by Winsor & Newton. Or actually, Winsor & Newton are Jackson's. They both do Van Dyke brown that is, I think, has got some black in it, so it reads as being significantly darker than, say, the Daniel Smith Van Dyke brown. And I like using the darker one with the black in it for the purposes of making an inky dark solution with the ultramarine blue. Kind of suits me. No, I want to find the shape of that beard. So that needs to go something going on down here that's like a ledge of dark, and then beneath it there's more beard again. I think I just need to lift out the bit below it so that it reads as being a little bit lighter. Feels like that beard could have a little bit of some shifting darks. I think I need to relocate some of the darks there once it's dry again. But the thing to focus on now might be this side of the spherical end of the nose. Of the mustache. I suppose I could begin that way, couldn't I? Just looking at that ear over here now, being a bit warm as well. So just knocking it back with some darks there. Maybe there could be bits of hair chiseled out and the mustache as it comes down to meet the mouth. Maybe not quite like that, but it's nice to know it's a possibility if I want to be more precise in how many hairs I left out there. I guess the mouth can be filled in a bit more. Right, what about this eye now? The shadow there. The upper eyelash line is a helpful one to find. Just looking at the direction of the eye here and how it runs along. Same line as the eyebrow was. Okay, and a touch of something for the colour part of the eye hairs. And something I've decided to use is Van Dyke Brown Ultramarine Blue. And the iris seems to sit over underneath this intersection of the dark that creates the point of that triangle. Yeah, I suppose it's roughly there. On the other side of it, maybe. I need to work into it again, but just to kind of place something there in order to see if I'm roughly getting the location true. Do something in here. Mm-hmm. think we're getting there. You know, it looks a bit strange, but I feel like the position is okay. And so I'm kind of keeping the faith that I just motor on with it, finding the colours in the area of the eye and what is it that stands out. There's a bright patch of skin about here, I think. With my dirty water, I mightn't be able to capture it now, but something a bit brighter there, lifting out. And then I want to go back to the iris as well in a minute. Let's see now. First, maybe I'll do some kind of a value on the lid. And I find that the eyelid can be warmer because of it, the skin on the eyelid and the things like the extremities, like the nose. Have a little bit more warmth than other areas do. Maybe a touch on the ear as well. Oh, I just got a cramp in my finger. That's funny. Right. So I'm holding the brush, I think. I'm going to lift off now some of the area around the pupil in the eye that I want to give a little light to. And at the same time, deepen the tone in the pupil itself. So I'm mixing brown and blue again, ultramarine blue, Van Dyke brown, to create a darker tone here. Roughly where the pupil might be, it's a nice dark colour, so I'm going to... Where? Outside? Oh, will you get midnight, Lil? Tune out and go and get midnight. See you in a minute.